Hey, Mixer. What's going on? Guru, come over here. Say hi to Mixer for me.
Yes. Hello.
Welcome to church. That's all I
Yeah.
got.
What are
I
you doing, DJ?
don't know. Somebody stop me. Somebody intervene.
So unique. So
Yeah, take it away
unique.
from
Yeah.
All
Oh
right,
my.
I'm gonna
Now
start
we can
the.
have another guessing game. We have two guessing games. Hi. Sorry, I had a little trouble getting on. Open up enough and getting on. You doing good?
Whoa, feedback. Headphones.
Yeah.
Who has that? I can't.
I think it was blue guy here.
Nick.
Nick.
Yep, it's Nick.
Yeah. What's up, Flips?
Nick, we're getting a lot of feedback through your mic. If you could plug some headphones in,
welcome to
please.
VR Church,
Hey,
everybody.
Good. Hey, good.
This is Flips. What's up, Flips? What's up, Uncle Glenn? Hey, Kristen. Hey, Maz.
Hey,
Kristen, I'm the good Glenn.
Whoa, who has the Is that Steven's mic?
But I'll hug you both anyway.
Yeah, we're good. We're chilled out.
Hey, Mixer. Hey, what's going on? We're gonna get started in a couple minutes. Thanks for hanging out today. Looking forward to we're doing two back-to-back services, so they're mini services. The technology for front rows down, so our limited numbers is our challenge. Usually we can have unlimited people in a room, but they're fixing that. So anyways. We're going to do 30 minutes here, 7:30 to 8 p.m. Eastern, and then 8 p.m. to 8:30. So we'll be live, I think, the whole time. I don't know if we'll take a break, but we'll find out.
You have a very nice facial expression.
Spaces.
Although at this angle, my eyes are very confused. At this angle, my eyes are very confused, and you had one.
Hey everyone, welcome to Virtual Reality Church. We're actually going to get started very shortly. We're going to cut the countdown short because we have two mini services to do today. And we have a lot of scripture to go through today that's going to be encouraging to you, I hope. And so we're going to get started very shortly. Feel free to come on in, grab a bench. There's some areas open seating in the back as well. And we'll get started in about 1 minute. Where did my camera go? Oh, it's over here. Sorry, Mixer, I lost you for a second. Hey, Glenn.
Hey.
How's it going?
Welcome to our church.
Hey. What's up?
How are you?
All right, let's go to the next one. This music is apropos for the environment. All right, Donna, I think you're up next. You still there, Donna?
Yes. Can you
Yeah.
hear me?
Yeah, you're up next after the countdown.
Okay.
Glenn number one, calm down.
Check out our new world. Sweet, huh? It's called Church World Nature. Hopefully the video doesn't lag out.
Okay, that was awesome. Hello, everyone, and welcome to VR Church. We are so thrilled that you have joined us today. No matter where you are on your spiritual journey, whether you believe in God or not, you are so welcome in this place. We do have a few requests. First, if you would be so kind to please stay off the stage during the service, that would be much appreciated. And if you would also stay muted during the service unless invited to unmute yourselves. We all wear different devices. Some wear headphones, others not. Some mics are more sensitive to others. So just to give everybody a great experience, if you could stay muted, that would be great. Now, we know that even when we're muted, we can share our feelings with others through emojis, right? So for those of you that might be new, down to your left, there's a circle menu. Click the happy face, and you'll get a circle of emojis. And feel free to share away as many as you like. Now, we know that respect is key to everyone enjoying their experience here. So we really ask that you be kind to each other. And for those of you that are new, if you feel if somebody's making you feel uncomfortable, please know that you are able to block somebody. If you click the avatar, a name badge appears ahead above their head, and there's a block button. Feel free to do that. We hope that everybody in this space feels welcome and accepted. So the last thing I want to say is we carry on conversations and post announcements through the week. So at our Discord channel. So please join the Discord channel and join in the conversation. Thanks, everyone.
Music dumb from all my unruly notes. Distance is dissonance moving close. Now I see, erase the scales from my eyes, then play the scale of my life. Chaos played off with a chord and a core with a source prevented through strife. And I've tasted suffering, I've been embraced by the painful buffering. I've been bound by doubt so loud right now, but a melody is made when you play these rusty keys. So we all gotta get pressed, tuned up like instruments. But I know all of life's people with sad whenever we remember this.
Drowning out the voices all around me through all of this chaos. You are writing a symphony, a symphony. And even in the madness, there is peace. Drowning out the voices all.
Man, I love that song. Man, that's a great song. I love that. God is working a symphony in your life. You might say, Pastor, I don't see that in my life. I just see kind of like darkness, addictions, frustrations. That's what you might see. But what you can't see behind the scenes is God working in your life in small and big and small ways. He is transforming you. He is writing a symphony of your life. I know there's mountains and valleys and things that you're facing. But listen, everyone in here is not excluded from God's love, God's mighty work to transform you. And he's doing something beautiful in your life. And you haven't even seen it yet. You haven't experienced it. He's still working it out. He's writing some notes. He's fixing some things. And you know what's brilliant about the divine is that he can even take tragedy. So maybe things that weren't, you know, part of his plan, he can take that and maybe some tragedy and hurt that you've gone through. And he'll say, give me that. I'm going to write a symphony out of that stuff. And I can't tell you the people that I've met that have gone through tragedy and have overcome that. And they are a shining light of God's love. And now they're helping people come out of tragedy as well. And man, it's beautiful what God is doing in your life, what he's going to do. And you haven't even seen it yet. You haven't seen the full work that he's doing. There's a Bible verse that says, he will complete the work that he began in you. And so there's a couple of thoughts about that. Well, one, he's begun a work in you. And two, he's going to complete it, right? Now, I'm with you. I wish it was like popping in the microwave, hit it like the minute, you know, microwave popcorn, you know, boom, out, you know. But our God, I heard a preacher this morning say, our God, it sounds weird, but if he's a crock pot God. Man, he's working something. He's got a recipe going. It's going to be a slow cooked thing. But at the end of the day, isn't that so much better to see what he's going to do? And you're going to come out of that and you're going to look back and you're like, wow, look what God did in my life. You know, and some of you think you're exempt. Some of you think maybe you screwed up too much. Some of you think you've made too many mistakes. Some of you feel like a failure. Some of you feel like, you know, that's nice words, Pastor. But, you know, that's not me. Well, I have good news for you. It is about you. It's about all of us. He loves us so much. And eye hath not seen and ear hath not heard of all the great things that God's going to do. Man, he's just getting started. He's just warming up, man. He's in your life. He's just kind of doing some layups. You know, he's just loosening it up, man. And then he's going to get at it. And he's going to go to work in your life. And you're going to be amazed. You're going to be amazed. And it's going to be a beautiful thing. So stay in faith and look for those things. Keep your spirit in faith in Jesus Christ because of the work he's going to do with you. Well, man, that wasn't the sermon, but man, that song got me thinking about all that. Well, a couple of things before we kind of dig into it. Sundays can be, you know, large gathering. We're all here. We got a service coming up right after that. We actually have four services every Sunday. And so this is the third one, the third of fourth. We were in VR chat earlier and AltSpace as well. But anyways, on Sunday, there's just a lot of people here. It's hard to have, like, you know, good conversation as far as, you know, discussion about the sermon. And we can certainly do that afterwards, 100%. But what we have here during the week is life groups. These are like small, you know, 6 to 10 people. Sometimes there's like 3 or 4 of us. And we'll hang out in Rec Room, AltSpace. Chuck leads a group on Tuesday nights, VR chat on Wednesdays, and then AltSpace and Rec Room. Chuck is right here in the middle, so make sure you friend him with the black avatar with the teal or blue trim right here. So make sure to send him a friend request. Chuck, you're about to get a lot of friend requests there because you got to join his life group on Tuesday nights at 8 p.m. And then Alina, where are you at? Oh, there's Alina. Throw up some emojis. Alina leads the AltSpace Life group on Thursdays. And then, so that's amazing. By the way, Pastor Alina has some medical dental things happening. So if you go up to her and say hi and she doesn't respond, it's because she has to stay muted and save her voice and get those things worked out. So she's not being rude to you. Pastor Alina is one of the nicest people. She'll definitely chat with you like typing on Discord. So feel free to DM her. And so anyways, this is a great opportunity for you. Well, we've been studying the life of Jesus Christ. We did, if you're just as your first time, actually, before we get into this, I always forget about this. If this is your first time at VR Church, Maybe, you know, just wave your hand or throw up one of these emojis, this hand-raising emoji right here. I'm just curious. All right, what's up, man? Good to see you, Brett and Sandman over there. What's going on? And, well, we got several. Moon, and there's a guest over there, Little Mayo, and I'm missing some people, Ryan. All right, good to see everyone. Someone way in the back, I think it's Yid. All right, well, everyone else, let's welcome our guest here. Throw up some heart emojis to say welcome to Virtual Reality Church. A question we get often, is this a real church and are you a real pastor? And the answer to both of those is yes. So welcome to that. And also, I have a camera here. We are live streaming to Mixer.com. We have a lot of people watching at Mixer. So let's say hi to them as well. Throw up any emoji you want to welcome our Mixer crowd. They are watching wherever they're at. Maybe they're traveling. Maybe they're at work or whatever the deal is. And they're just kind of tuning into Mixer. So we want to say hello to you, Mixer folk. Thanks for hanging out today. And let's continue with our service. There we go. Move the camera there for our Mixer folks. But we've been studying the life of Jesus. And specifically, we've been looking at the life of Jesus through a guy named John. So John was a follower of Jesus Christ. He saw the things that happened. He heard. And he wrote down what he saw and what he heard. And the things that he wrote down were amazing. They are beautiful because we thought God was this angry God who's going to like throw lightning bolts down and cast judgment and the gods are angry, right? But John was like, no, actually, the gods aren't angry. The God is full of love. Remember John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave Jesus Christ. So does that sound like someone that wants to destroy the world or someone that wants to save us? Man, it's such a beautiful thing that we discovered. And then we skipped over to 1st, 2nd, and 3rd John. So we're studying 1st John, who is written by, guess who, John. And he continues this theme about God's love for the world. And so we've been studying that. We are now on chapter 4. So we're going to go over there to the forest over there and read through John chapter 4. But I want to encourage you, if this is your first time, if you're just kind of discovering us, or really anybody, to go back and read 1 John chapter 1, 1 John chapter 2, and 1 John chapter 3. They're real short, and you'll be able to read those very quickly. The way I recommend it, and you can do it however you want. Maybe you want to go, you know, buy a Bible or look. There's some ton of websites, but I love the YouVersion Bible app. It's for your smartphone. It's an Android. It's an iOS. And when you download that Bible app, you can really just find any. You can just quickly go to any point of the Bible. And then here's my favorite part. You can pick the translation. Because a lot of Bibles, like maybe you've like went to it, you're like, I'm going to try to read the Bible. And you're like, I'm not going to read the Bible. Because it was like, hitherto come forth thou unto me, the, you know, all that stuff. You're like, okay, that's good. I'm done. What's on Netflix, right? So what the Bible, YouVersion Bible app does, you can pick your translation for modern translations, modern paraphrases. And man, that'll do wonders for you that like are, you know, interested in reading the Bible, because then the Bible is like understandable. Like I switched to a translation and that really suited me well. And I was like, man, I could understand the Bible way better than whatever translation I was using before. So definitely check that out. And I definitely encourage you to read 1 John chapter 1 and 1 John chapter 1, 2, and 3. But before we get to 1 John chapter 4, let me give you a quick recap, because some of you weren't here. 1 John chapter 1, John the writer says this, basically, in a nutshell, says, hey guys, Jesus is real. We've seen him, we've heard him, we've touched him. He has the words of life. He loves us. He wants to be in relationship with us. He wants to forgive us. And that's beautiful, because maybe this whole Jesus thing was starting to become a conspiracy, right? I mean, if you heard of someone dying and burying and you know, got buried and rose again, like on Easter, right? You'd think, you know, back then, you know, Easter is kind of like integrated into our culture a bit. And whether you believe it or not, you still understand the general idea. But back then, that was weird stuff. And so John was like, well, let me clear it up, because maybe people are thinking that this Jesus thing is fake. Maybe it's a conspiracy. So he's like, guys, listen, Jesus is real. We've seen him. We've heard him. We've touched him. He has the words of life. He wants to be in relationship with us. He wants to forgive us. And this was new, by the way. This was new because the religious establishment of that day was very arrogant. A lot of rules and regulations and requirements and an endless list of demands and God this and God that. And he was like, John's like, no. God loves you. and he wants to bring life and light into your world. You know, it's not about that, but some of those things might actually be good, but it's not about that. It's about this life that God wants to bring into your life. So that was John chapter 1. And then not only that, he kind of amps it up. John chapter 2, he's like, not only is Jesus real, John chapter 1, John chapter 2, your relationship with God can be real. And this is really important because I think, you know, many of the people thought, you know, this whole faith in Jesus and God thing was some metaphysical thing out in the air, just kind of floating around. But he's like, no, this is actually your relationship with God can be real. This faith that you have in God is going to be seen by your love for one another. That's beautiful. The way that you know you're living, you're walking with the divine is if you have love towards one another. As a matter of fact, he says, don't have hate towards people. Show love towards one another. And that's a huge emphasis on the book of John, 1 John. Like when you read all of 1 John, you're going to come to the conclusion, oh, I need to be loving people. I need to be showing them love. I need to be encouraging them. I need to help people meet, you know, whatever needs they have as best as I can, you know, help their needs. And it's so clear. So Jesus is real. Your relationship with God can be real. And then 1 John chapter 3 was this beautiful, like, okay, I want you to experience it. And so he says, see how much the Father loves us, or Father meaning God. See how much God loves us. He calls us his children. And that's amazing because we're not just religious peons. We're not just, you know, random numbers and a cog in the wheel. We are sons and daughters. We are children of the Most High God. And that is a beautiful thing because, you know, like I'm here in my neighborhood and I'm sure there's nice kids out there. And if they came up to my door, I'm sure I'd try to help them if I could with whatever they wanted. But the children in my home have special privileges, man. They can go raid the fridge. They can go play the video games. You know, there's this whole element of being in the family, being my son, being my daughter. And that's the same thing with God. You're not just some random person out there cogging the wheel. You are not a random number. You are a son. You are a daughter. You are a child of the Most High God. And so there's all other things in 1 John chapter 1, 1 John chapter 2, 1 John chapter 3 that you got to go back and read because I'm missing some amazing things, by the way. But that's just a fundamental recap. So I encourage you to go back and read it and pray through it. But now, so you would think, all right, God loves me. God loves me and God loves the world. And that's great. We're going to live happily ever after. Well, no, John, the writer, wanted us to be careful about something because he does say, hey, listen, you know what? There are false prophets. There are cults. There are things that seem to represent that we think we know that seem religious or they're spiritual, but they're actually not. And so I said we're going to go over there, but I think just for time, we're going to stay right here and look at some of the scripture, if you don't mind. And then maybe afterwards, feel free to walk over in that area. And so here's what he says. And actually, before I read that, let me just talk to you about one quick story. I got permission from somebody on Discord to tell this story because it was a bit personal. I said, hey, do you mind if I tell this? They said, it was fine. And so the short story is this. She had a friend that went off to a religious camp. And when they went off to that religious camp, she didn't see him for like a week or two. And then he came back and something changed about him. He was a little bit more angry, a little bit more combative, a little bit religious in the negative sense of the word. There's a positive sense in the word religious, but there was an arrogant religious to him. And she was really concerned. She said, Pastor, what do I do? Well, I don't know what happened at that religious camp. And so John actually kind of talks about this, is that there are things that claim to be spiritual, claim to be religious, claim to be of God, but they're not. And he says, listen, I wish we could live happily ever after. You know, kumbaya, we love each other. We're taking care of each other. We're serving. We're encouraging. We're meeting each other's needs. But he says there are false things in this world that are not of love. And I think of that kid that went to religious camp and came back. If he had come back and was full of love and like, let's go feed the homeless and let's go, you know, serve our neighbors, you know, then I'd be like, yeah, that's awesome. But when he came back with religious arrogance, this is what John, 1 John chapter 4 is all about. So let's read through it really quick. It says this. Let me fix the camera for our mixer friends. It says this, dear friends, do not believe everyone who claims to speak by the Spirit. Okay. He says, you must test them to see if the spirit they have comes from God. For there are many false prophets in the world. Hey, listen, there are a lot of things that claim to be of God. And I wish, you know, that we lived in a society or a culture or, you know, where we can engage in spiritual things and there wasn't cults and arrogant religion. But unfortunately, John says, you're going to have to watch out for that. And you're going to have to be careful of that. Don't believe everyone who claims to be speak by the Spirit. You must test everyone. This is really important. You, each individual person, you must do the testing. Okay? It's good to ask your friends. It's good to ask your pastor. It's good to ask your priest. That's all good. But at the end of the day, you need to think for yourself and you need to do the test, which might be uncomfortable for some of us because we're like, man, I'd rather have someone just tell me, is this good or bad? That can be fine to have that conversation and talk, but the Bible is telling us that you must think for yourself and you must do the test to see if this is from the Spirit of God. And that's what he says, you must test them. Well, some of you say, well, I need help. How do I test them? Well, what has John been talking about this whole time? Love, loving one another. Man, if you go into a religious environment, whether it's a church or a pastor or a priest or, you know, all these things that we can interact with and you sense the love, then that's a good check. You know, all right, let me put them through the test. That's a check. Oh, and by the way, that includes me, you know, I'm, you know, Pastor DJ leading virtual reality church. And hey, I thought you were on weren't you on like the Today Show and stuff? Yeah. But guess what? You still need to test what I say. Don't just take my word for it. You need to go back and read through 1 John. Well, pastor's been saying this and pastor's been saying that. Well, let me go check. Yeah, that's exactly what the Bible has been saying. And there's other places where the Bible says you need to test things. You individually go back and read and pray and test me every week. Anybody that gets up here, Pastor Bismick, Pastor Alina, me, you need to put us through the test. Okay. And then here's what the next part says. And I see the time, admin, so I'll make sure to keep it going here. It says, this is how we know if they have the Spirit of God. If a person claiming to be a prophet, acknowledges that Jesus Christ came in a real body, that person has the Spirit of God. So the first thing is to test with love, right? You know, that kid came back from religious camp. There was no love there. So that's a big warning sign. Red flag goes up. And the other one, if someone or something or an institution or organization claims to be Christian, claims to be spiritual, but they don't acknowledge Jesus and that he came in a real body, that's a problem. And this is particularly sensitive for John, because remember when we read John and Jesus went head to head with the arrogant, entrenched religious system of that day? And remember that system was like, oh, you're not from God. And oh, that miracle is from the devil. You remember all that? He was like, listen, don't reject Jesus. This isn't some metaphysical thing kind of floaty out there. No, Jesus is real. This faith stuff is real. This is like, I don't know, more than real, like hyper reality. I don't know. But he's saying we need to acknowledge that Jesus actually came in a real body. This really happened. But if someone claims to be a prophet and does not acknowledge the truth about Jesus, that person is not from God. Such a person has a spirit of Antichrist, which you heard is coming in the world and indeed is already here. Now, what I really want to say is this to our atheist friends and our agnostic friends. This is not directed towards you, right? So some of my friends that are atheists and agnostic would say, I don't think Jesus is real. You know, he's talking about those that are claiming to be a prophet. So I just wanted to make that clear. But you belong to God, my dear children. You have already won a victory over those people because the spirit who lives in you is greater than the spirit who lives in the world. Those people belong to this world, so they speak from the world's viewpoint, and the world listens to them. I love this. You belong to God. You're not a peon. You're not a slave. You're his child. You've already won. No, that's beautiful. And then he says it again, but we belong to God. And those who don't know God, and those who know God, listen to us. If they do not belong to God, they do not listen to us. That is how we know if someone has a spirit of truth or the spirit of deception. So when that kid came back from religious camp, did you see the spirit of truth and love, or do you see religious arrogance and deception? So the Bible, I know this is uncomfortable maybe for some of us who are like, man, I'd rather have someone just tell me. No, the Bible's saying you have to put it to the test. You have to activate your brain. You have to think for yourself and come to that conclusion. You have to put it to the love test and put it to the Jesus test. And that's very, very important. And then I love how he just keeps repeating this theme. You know, when you read other parts of the Bible, you're like, I don't know what the heck passage of scripture is talking about. Well, you can't say that about 1 John, because he repeats it over and over again. I feel like, wait, didn't I just read this? No, he keeps repeating it. Dear friends, let us continue to love one another, for love comes from God. Anyone who loves is a child of God. Anyone who loves is a child of God and knows God, but anyone who does not love does not know God, for God is love. God showed how much he loved us by sending his one and his only son, Jesus, into the world so that we might have eternal life through him. This is real love. Not that we love God, but that he loved us and sent his son as a sacrifice to take away our sins. Whatever you're going through, whatever the junk is, whatever the guilt and the regret is, God wants to take that stuff away. He loves you so much. And he says this, dear friends, since God loved us that much, we surely ought to love each other. We need to love each other. We need to help each other, encourage each other. Let's not be discouraging or toxic. Let's show love and be kind to one another, not just in words or, hey, you know, just really meeting each other's needs and really encouraging each other. And I see we just got about a minute here, so let me finish this up. This part is crazy, actually, right here. This part right here. No one has ever seen God, but if we love each other, God lives in us, and his love is brought to full expression in us. The reason this is nuts right here, the reason this is crazy, is because the Bible actually admits, you know, this God, Jesus thing, you can't see him. This is faith. This is believing in stuff that you can't see. But with God's love inside our spirit, and when we express that love, people see the divine. So, you know, I believe, by the way, don't get me wrong, I believe in like intellectual arguments and science and historical documents and all these things that could prove that Jesus exists, all these things that could prove that God and the Bible are true. That's fine. But what the writer is saying is, don't forget this. When you have love towards one another, you're actually showing that God is real. That is going to actually, at the end of the day, Riley, prove to someone other, saying, like, prove to one another. Let's see, hold on. Let me mute him real quick. There we go. And you can kick him, Chuck, if he continues. And his love is brought to full expression in us. And God has given us his spirit as proof that we live in him and he in us. That love is actually the proof. Like, don't forget, those things are great. Intellectual and science and, you know, this and that. I love those things. And if you listen to Chuck for any amount of time, and you're going to get convinced, because he's a science dude. In addition, and also, and maybe at the top, is this idea of love that proves God is real. That's at the end of the day going to be like the nail in the coffin, right? So to speak. All right. So furthermore, we have seen with our own eyes and now testify that the Father sent his Son to be the Savior of the world. All who declare that Jesus is the Son of God have God living in them, and they live in God. We know how much God loves us, and we have put our trust in his love. God is love, and all who live in love live in God, and God lives in them. And as we live in God, our love grows more perfect, so we will not be afraid of him on the day of judgment, but we can face him with confidence because we live like Jesus here in this world. And how did Jesus live? With love. Such love has no fear, because perfect love expels all fear. If we are afraid, it is for fear of punishment. And this shows that we have not fully experienced his perfect love. We love each other because he first have loved us. If someone says, and let me just skip to the bottom of here, and he has given us this commandment, those who love God must also love their fellow believers. So that's like the recurring theme, man. It's hard to deny what actually 1 John is talking about. And that is how Jesus wants us to live. Well, Pastor, what about, you know, going to church and giving money to this and doing that? All those things are great, but well, let's put those aside for a second. The way that God wants us to live is a life of love. And 1 John was super clear about that. And that's not my words. That's the words that come from the Bible and from 1 John. Well, okay, I just ran a little bit over, and so I need to run over to the next service. So sorry to cut it off short and to run. But Chuck, if you don't mind coming up here and praying for us to close. And then after Chuck is done praying, feel free to unmute your mics. Let's hang out. Let's chat. Star Child is here, and she'll be back at the prayer area back there. If you need any type of prayer, I want you to head back to the prayer area. And also, Star Child is on Discord, so maybe if you don't want to go back there, you can also type it in our Discord prayer channel. All right, thanks so much, Chuck.
Okay. All right, dear God, thank you so much for this opportunity for us to come together and learn about your will. And Lord, just give us the ability.
What's up, Mixer? Going to the second service over here. What's up, guy? What's up, Brett?
Yes, that's me. Hello. Hi, Donna.
Hey, I'm going to put up the screen real quick. I'll be right back.
All right, DJ, I got to head out.
Nice to meet you.
All right, see you, dude.
See ya.
Peace out.
Nice to meet you, too.
Okay, let me put the screen up here. Nope, not at that angle. Yeah, that was perfect.
Is this the same as the last service?
Yeah, yeah, this will be the same one.
Okay.
All right, let me put up the screen. It's at the wrong angle, though, so let me... How do I need to angle this? Ooh, that's a really bad angle. Maybe right here? Perfect. All right, so let me... Oops.
Sorry, not to distract you, but are you going to do the same 1 minute countdown as in the last service?
Yeah. Yeah, I'll do that.
Okay.
Oh, I didn't mean to do that. Shoot. Hold on 1 second. Yeah, the 1 minute. Yeah, sorry, I'm trying to get this. Sorry if I'm distracted talking to you. I can't.
No, I won't ask anymore. That's all I want to know. Thanks.
Oh, yeah, no problem. All right, so we're going to sync URLs here. Okay, that's locked. And we're going to resize it right about there. How's that look? And countdown. Hey, everybody. Welcome to Virtual Reality Church. We're going to get started in a few minutes. We probably won't do the full countdown, but yeah, we'll get started shortly. Thanks for hanging out. What's up, Dorito?
Hey-o.
How you doing, buddy?
I'm doing pretty well. How about you?
Doing pretty good. I'm pretty good. All right. Uh-oh. Brett's here. Hey, little Mayo. What's up, guest? Michael. Hey, Sam. Hey, Sam, man. What's up? How's it going? Good to see you. Mr. Pete, the architect. I'll stay at the welcome desk. What's up, Ryan? How's it going? Good to see you. I can't hear you if you're talking, but good to see you anyway. Hey, Mr. Architect. I have to follow up with you on DM to get a...
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, well, I want to try to do a couple of things, but anyways, I'll message you on Discord.
All right, Mark.
Let me check. Oh, I'm like stuck. Let me back this up. Oh, I'm literally stuck. Oh, there we go. Hey, everyone. Hey, Yid. Hey, David. What's up, Gaither? Hey, guys. Okay. And there you go. Let me check. Let's see who's on Discord right now. Oh, I can't. It's on full screen. I'll have to check it later. I have it on full screen because it makes a better video playback. But, hey, Dale.
Hey, Pastor DJ.
Hey. How's it going?
Good. Let's see. I've got a question for you.
Yeah, yeah, what's up?
I caught the second half of the first service.
Yeah.
And when you were talking about John, did those passages come from that Bible that you were talking about, the translation Bible?
Yeah, the YouVersion Bible app.
Oh, did you? Would.
Yeah, yeah. And
it's
called the.
Keep lagging really bad.
Yeah, yeah. I hear a lag too. That's my. Yeah, it's YouVersion. YOU. And then version, what YouVersion Bible app. And then if you download that, you can pick your translation.
All right, thank you.
And the one I like, the one we were using is NLT, with the letters NLT for New Living Translation.
All right, thank you. I have to look into that.
Yeah, yeah, no problem. Let me do one of these. Alright, I see Octane on the chat. Crystal, what's up? Oop, hopefully I didn't script the video there. Hold on. Hey, Donna, I think we just need your megaphone on, or I think it's not on.
I am so sorry. Sorry about that, guys. So welcome, everyone, to VR Church. We're so thrilled that you've joined us today. No matter where you are on your spiritual journey, whether you believe in God or not, we hope you feel welcome and accepted in this place. We do have a few requests. Our first is, if you'd be so kind as to stay off the stage during the sermon, during the service today, that would be so much appreciated. And we also ask that you please stay muted during the service unless invited to unmute yourself. We all wear different devices, some headphones, others not, some mics are more sensitive than others. So just to keep it a great experience for everyone, if you could stay muted, that would help everyone. Now, even when we're muted, we know that we can share our feelings with the people that are in this place, and that's through emojis. Now, for those that might be new to AllSpace, if you look at that menu down to your left, you'll see a happy face. If you click on that happy face, you get an entire circle of emojis, hearts and claps and happy faces. So please feel free to share away. That's a great way to let people around you and Pastor DJ know how you're feeling. Now, respect is key in VR and for everyone to enjoy their experience here. So we ask that you all be kind to each other. For those that are new, just a quick note that if someone is making you feel uncomfortable at all, you do have the ability to block that person. If you click your controller on an avatar on the name badge, you'll see in the middle there's a block button. Just click that. And you won't hear or see them, and they won't hear or see you either. So the last thing, just want to let you know that we do carry on conversations. We post announcements and have conversations, reminders about events, etc., on our Discord channel. So please join the channel, and Welcome everyone today. We're glad you're here. Thanks.
Music dumb from all my unruly notes. Distance is dissonance, moving close. Now I see, erase the scales from my eyes, then play the scale of my life. Chaos played off with a chord and a chord with a source prevented through strife. And I've tasted suffering, I've been embraced by the painful buffering. I've been bound by doubt so loud right now, but a melody is made when you play these rusty keys. So we all gotta get pressed, tuned up like instruments. But I know all of life's tempo is set whenever we remember this.
There's peace, drowning out the voices all around me through all of this chaos. You are writing a symphony, and even in the madness, there's peace, drowning out the voices all around me through all of this chaos. You are writing.
Man, I love that song right there. That is a beautiful song. That's a very powerful song. God is writing a symphony in your life, and that's beautiful. That's exciting. Some of you might not feel that way. Some of you are like, Pastor, there's no way God is working. Oh, am I muted that whole time? Oh, man, Mixer the whole time was listening to me preach. Man, I was preaching that song, and I was muted. My bad. Mixer, you heard me. I think no one else did. So let me say that again, man. God is working in your life. He is writing a symphony. It's such a beautiful thought, the symphony that God is writing. Some of you are like, no, I don't think he's writing a symphony. I think he's writing like a horror score, right? Things aren't going well in my life. It's a little bit hellish. Yeah, I feel you, but he is. He's working in your life. He has love for you. He's calling us to live in a new dimension, a new paradigm. And this is a paradigm of love. He wants us to experience it to his full. He's doing a work in our lives. And there's this passage of scripture. I love it. It says, that God, he who began a good work in you, is going to complete it. So he started something, and he's going to finish that, what he started. And I know that we wish it was more like a microwave thing, you know, put in the microwave, you know, it comes out. But God is he's, think of him like a, I heard a pastor this morning say, he's like a crock pot God. He's, you know, not only doing a symphony, he's getting the recipe together. It's a slow cook. And how much better is it going to be? So I know life's tough. You're in the valley. You're stuck in the water or in the mud, and you're discouraged, you're depressed. But man, God has something for us that we can't even imagine. We haven't even thought the thoughts. He has dreams upon dreams. He has things that he wants us to experience, and that's his love for us. He just loves us so much, and that's a beautiful thing. That's going to change how we live our lives to understand that love. Well, I'm not here to talk about that song, even though that was beautiful. I want to get to my sermon, but one thing that we like to do during the week is to gather in small groups, because on Sunday there's a lot going on. We have 4 services over VR chat and AltSpace, and so, you know, sometimes it's hard to have, like, you know, good conversations and you know, just to, you know, talk about things. And so we certainly can, by the way, after church and all that. But we have some dedicated times during the week that you can check out: Rec Room, AltSpace, VR chat. And so feel free to join us in one of those. And like Donna was saying, on Discord is the best way to keep up to date on what's going on. You say, Pastor, I'm on a ton of Discord channels. Fair enough. But come swing by at least. And if you want to leave, you know, that's fine. No hard feelings. But come check it out. Chuck right here in the black avatar with the light blue or light green or whatever you call it, light blue. Teal is right here. He leads the life groups on Tuesday nights in AltSpace. So make sure everyone friend him. Everyone send him a friend request, Chuck. And then where's Alina? Alina's back there. What's up, Alina? Throw up some emojis. Pastor Alina is back there. She leads the life groups on Thursday in AltSpace. So make sure to send her a friend request. And she has some like medical dental things going on, so she can't speak right now. So if you go and try to talk to her and she ignores you, she's not ignoring you. So send her a DM on Discord if you want to connect. But Pastor Lena, we hope you feel better soon, and hopefully all that the appointments and stuff works out quickly for you. And actually, we should pray for her star child. I think we need to make that happen after the service, star child. Let's do that in the prayer area, if you don't mind, Lena. I'm putting you on the spot there. Well, we've been studying the life of Jesus. Is this your first time to VR Church? Actually, now that I think about it, we haven't even done that yet. If you've never been to VR Church before, this is your first time, you're like, man, what's going on here? I've never been here. Raise your hand. Maybe throw up one of these emojis so we could see who you might be. And maybe these are regulars. All right, we've got a couple guests here. What's up? What's up, Jax? Good to see you, my friend. All right, we got some visitors here today. Good to see everyone. And let's send up some emojis for our new friends. So welcome to Virtual Reality Church. And and we can't forget our Discord friends right here. Let me bring the camera. We got people watching on Mixer.com. They're watching here on the camera. So hey, Mixer, good to see you. I know Octane and Crystal were there chatting. And everyone else, let's give them some emojis just to welcome our Discord people. Discord Mixer people. And yeah, thanks for hanging out today. Nothing but love for you on Mixer. Good stuff. Well, like I was saying, we were studying the life of Jesus. And hold on, this camera angle is bad. Sorry, guys. Yeah, that should be good right there. We've been studying the life of Jesus. And in particular, specifically, we've been studying the life of Jesus through the book of John. So John was this guy who was a follower of Jesus Christ. He actually wrote down the things that he saw and he heard Jesus do. And John wrote down some amazing things. It was just beautiful. And so we've been studying that. But then after we finished John, we went over to 1 John. He wrote some more things. It's called 1 John, 2 John, and 3 John. I don't know why those titles were more interesting, but that's what they did. So right now we finished John, and right now we're in 1 John. And oh man, this is such good news. This is so encouraging, because we thought God was an angry God. We thought he wanted to send lightning bolts down to the earth. We thought he was angry. And what we discovered, he's actually full of love. Remember John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only son. Man, does that sound like an angry God that wants to cast judgment? Or does that sound like a God that's full of love? And that's from John 3:16. And then when he wrote 1 John, I feel like he was taking this thing up to a whole other level. He was like, oh man, this Jesus story was crazy. But now look what he's done in my life. And he talks about love. And so we're going to be talking about 1 John chapter. We're in chapter 4 now in 1 John. And it's a theme of love. That's why we're calling it the Summer of Love here at VR Church. And let me give you a quick recap of what we learned in 1 John chapter 1 through 3. So basically on 1 John chapter 1, the writer, he said this. Hey guys, listen. This Jesus person, he's actually real. We've seen him, we've heard him, we've touched him. He has the words of life. He wants to be in fellowship with us or in a relationship. He wants to forgive us. And it's just good news after good news, man. You can't even handle all the good news that's just being poured out in 1 John. And it was beautiful. And then in 2 John, it takes it up to another level. He goes to another level. He goes, not only is Jesus real, but your relationship with God can be real. It's not some metaphysical floaty thing out there that's just, you know, crossing our fingers and, oh, hopefully, I don't know. No, he's like, it can be real. And one of the ways that it can be real is by showing love to one another. It's faith and love. Well, Pastor, I thought it was all about, you know, rules and regulations and, our, you know, endless list of demands. No, put that away. Because John's setting the record straight. It's about faith and it's about love. And that's actually quite controversial at the time, because when John was writing this, the entrenched religious system was very arrogant and very hateful. And when John wrote this, he was like, it's not about that. It's about love for one another, a radical love, not just one that we just say, hey, we love each other. He's like, I want to see your love. I want to see it in action. I want to see you encouraging each other. I want to see you helping each other. I want to see you meeting needs. And that's such a beautiful thing. So, 1 John, that's the recap, chapter 1, chapter 2, and chapter 3. And you would think, like this guy here on the screen, man, we would just live happily ever after. The story's over. We're just going to, you know, live a life of love, which is beautiful. And yes, that's true. But the writer was concerned about something. He was really concerned about some false prophets or some false teaching. And he really wanted to set the record straight about that. And let me tell you a little story before we get into 1 John. So 1 John chapter 4, discerning false prophets and loving one another. Because not everything that claims to be like spiritual or religious or a church or a pastor or a priest or whatever, not everything is of God. Man, there's some crazy out there, y'all. There's some cults. There's some arrogant religion. There's a lot of crazy things out there. And John's like, listen, we got to deal with the crazy. We got to be careful with the crazy. And let me tell you a story before we get into this scripture here. I got permission to tell the story. This gal on Discord had sought me for some advice. And I asked her if I could share the story. And she said it would be okay. It was just like a week or two ago where she said, hey, Pastor, I have a good friend. And she's my boyfriend. And he went off to a religious camp for like a week or two. And before religious camp, everything was great. You know, we'd play pool, we'd listen to music together. You know, it was just a positive experience. And then she said, when he came back from religious camp, he like changed, but not in a good way. He was like angry, arrogant, combative. He was like, Pastor, what do I do? And this is what 1 John was talking about, because there are things that claim to be religious, but are actually full of hate, arrogance, judgmentalism. And John's like, no, that's not how we should be living. Because, hey, listen, fair enough. Someone says, I claim, you know, maybe this religious camp says, we claim to speak for God. And fair enough. You're like, okay. And then you listen to it and you're like, oh, I guess this is how I should be living. And John's like, no. Don't believe everything you hear. And we're going to talk, let's talk about this more. 1 John chapter 4. Let's start reading so you can see exactly what I'm talking about. So here's what John says in the first verse. He says, dear friends, do not believe everyone who claims to be speak by the Spirit. You must test them to see if the Spirit they have comes from God. For there are many false prophets in this world. You know, I wish it wasn't like that. I wish there wasn't cults or weird religious things out there. But he says, hey, listen, there are false things out there. And he says, do not believe everyone. You must test them. You must put them to the test. Now, this is where it gets a little bit difficult, because the Bible is talking about you, like individually you. So that's fine. You want to talk to a friend, a family member, a religious, maybe a pastor. That's great. But at the end of the day, he says, you must come to the conclusion. You must think for yourself. You must put them through the test, not someone else. That can be great to have those conversations, but you must. And I know for some of us, we have different personalities, and some of you are like, man, I just want someone to tell me, right? Just sit, write the blog, write the review on Yelp. You know what I mean? Can we just do it that way? And no, the Bible says, no, you have to engage in this. You have to activate your brain and you have to put them through the test. And some of you might say, well, what the heck is the test? You know, how do I know? Well, what have we been studying so far? We've been studying undeniably the idea, or not the idea, the reality of love. And that is one of the first things you put them through. So back to that story, if that guy had come back from religious camp and was like, oh man, I got love for the world. Let's go feed the poor. And let's go, you know, take care of the widows and visit those in prison. I'd have been like, wow, that's a, you know, whatever religious camp he went to, man, that's of God, man. Look how he came back full of fire and love. But when he came back full of arrogance, when he came back full of combativeness and religious arrogance, this is what John was talking about. You must put them through the test. Is it, do you sense love? Do you see God's love being expressed through their spirit? Then that's a great way to test them. And then he goes on a little further. He says, this is how we know if they have the spirit of God. If a person claiming to be a prophet acknowledges that Jesus Christ came in a real body, that person has the spirit of God. So listen, I just want to be clear for all my atheist friends out there, all my agnostic friends. Listen, they're not talking about you. You're not a false thing. You know, he's talking about people that claim to be a prophet or a pastor or a church or a religious institution. Did they pass the love test? Good. Do they acknowledge that Jesus Christ came in a real body? Because this is important. This faith stuff, this spirituality stuff, it's not, like I said, some metaphysical thing out there. This is real. This is more than real. This is hyper reality. And John was probably really sensitive to this because remember back in the book of John when Jesus went head to head with the Pharisees and even those religious, the entrenched religious system said to Jesus, you're not real. Your miracles are fake. You know, all of that. He's like, no, listen, we need to acknowledge that this Jesus Christ actually came in a real body. This is actually really, really important. But if someone claims to be a prophet and does not acknowledge the truth about Jesus, well, what's the truth about Jesus? Well, his love. That person is not from God. Such a person has a spirit of Antichrist, which you have heard is coming into the world and indeed is already here. The truth about Jesus is his love. And there is Antichrist, or, you know, what does Jesus represent? He represents love. What's the opposite of that? That Antichrist is hate. Jesus represents light and life and freedom. What's the opposite of that? Darkness and control and manipulation. And he says, man, unfortunately, that exists in this world. There are things that claim to speak for God, claim to be spiritual, claim to be a church, claim to be that. But you have to put them through the test. You have to see if they pass the love test. And then you have to see if they pass the Jesus test. And by the way, that includes me. That includes Pastor DJ and Virtual Reality Church. Don't believe everything I say. I'm not no cult leader. You have to like go back and read 1 John and read through it and pray and read and come to the conclusion yourself. Put the things that I say, the things that I teach, the way we operate through the love test, put it through the Jesus test. And that is what the writer wants us to do. We don't want to lead people astray, but you got to put it through the test. And Pastor Alina is a wonderful person and Pastor Bismick, but whenever they teach, when Pastor Alina gets up here or Pastor Bismick, or maybe at Life Group and Chuck and whoever's leading, put it through the test. Think for yourself. I know it's uncomfortable, but listen, there's a lot of false things out there that's going to try to pull you away from the love of God. And man, John doesn't want you to spend a single second living in arrogance or in darkness or in hate. Man, we don't have time for that. And that's why he's like, man, watch out for those false things. I wish it didn't exist. I wish cults didn't exist. I wish weird religious arrogance and judgmentalism didn't exist, but it does. And you can't believe everything you read, put it through the, or can't believe everything you hear. Oop, am I crashing? And I crashed. Am I still streaming? VR Church, can you, Mixer, am I still streaming? Yes, you're still streaming. Or I can't get it through my headset. No, that was weird. That was weird, y'all. Is it a black screen right now? Hopefully you'll see some soon. All right, that was strange. Let me get back into I got kicked out of church. False prophet. I can't even get back in because the time is up. No way. That's crazy. I need to extend the time, don't I? Somebody send me an invite. If you're watching this. Oh, that's... Let me see. Can I get back in there? Shoot. Someone send me an invite. The room is closed. Alina. Can you send? I'm texting an invite. I got knocked out. Hey, Carrie, can you call Alina to see if she can send me an invite back into the room? Oh, there we go. Beautiful. She sent it to me. Visit now. Okay. Well, I don't know what to tell you about that. Hey, everyone. All right. That was random. Thank you. Thank you for the emojis. My internet's fine. Oculus can just completely shut down. Thank you for the invites. Yes. That got me in because I was texting Alina, like, send me an invite. Okay, so sorry about that. Let me do a couple of things here. I'm going to have to reset the browsers here because I can't see the screen anymore. So sorry, give me 1 second and then we'll wrap this up here in no time. And thank you for your patience. I was wondering what was going on. And then poor Alina can't speak. I'm not laughing at you, Alina. I'm just laughing at what was just the whole thing. okay. You know what I mean. Okay, so I'm going to... Oh, sorry. I'm going to...
All right, DJ. So I can see the screen, so I'm going to go ahead and just read the verse while you get it pulled up there. It just says, but if someone claims to be a prophet and does not acknowledge the truth about Jesus, that person is not from God. Such a person has the spirit of Antichrist, which you heard is coming into the world and indeed is already here.
Do you guys see the new screen at all?
I don't have a microphone. Oh.
Do you all see the new screen?
Yes.
Oh, you do? Okay, perfect, perfect, perfect. Okay. It might be, when I get knocked out like that, it knocks out the old screen for me, so I can't see it, but the new screen should work right here. So we'll just work with this. All right, so thank you. So let's see here. We were over, someone has acknowledged the truth, Antichrist. Okay. And I love this right here. Just a couple more thoughts and we'll close here. But you belong to God, my dear children. You have already won a victory over these people because the spirit who lives in you is greater than the spirit who lives in this world. Those people belong to this world, so they speak from the world's viewpoint, and the world listens to them. So, yeah, this arrogant religious system lives in this world system. But what I do love, hold on, I just screwed it up here. There we go. What I do love is that top idea. You belong to God. You are a child of the Most High God. You are a son. You are a daughter. And that's such a beautiful thing. And then he repeats the idea again, but we belong to God. And those who know God listen to us. If they do not belong to God, they do not listen to us. This is how we know someone has the spirit of truth or the spirit of deception. So, you know, we're kind of, you know, bypassing a lot of things, but that's what Life Group is for, man. Chuck and Alina, I hope you delve deep into some of these concepts and ideas. And so that'll be good for you to do that. But it says here, dear friends, he's kind of like a, almost like a broken record. He doesn't want us to miss the point. Let us continue to love one another, for love comes from God. Anyone who loves is a child of God and knows God, but anyone who does not love does not know God, for God is love. God showed how much he loved us by sending his one and only son into the world so that we might have eternal life through him. This is real love. Not that we love God, but that he loved us and sent his son as a sacrifice to take away our sins. Man, that is real love. And then so he says this, dear friends, since God loved us that much, we surely ought to love each other. Man, so you ever read a book and you kind of feel like, man, didn't I just read this part? You kind of flip back. Wait, I thought I just read this. Well, John, you did read it. You've read it like 10 times already. We ought to love each other. Some other books of the Bible or passages of the Bible, you're like, man, I don't know what the heck it's talking about. This is some confusing stuff. Well, John's not confusing. He's clear. Love one another. And then just a couple of final thoughts, and I'll end with this one, because this right here is crazy. It says, no one has ever seen God, but if we love each other, God lives in us, and his love is brought to full expression in us. This is crazy. Well, a couple of thoughts. One, the Bible's real clear about this God, faith, and Jesus stuff being faith. You don't see it, but you do believe. It's real clear about that. But it does say this, is that if we love each other, God becomes real. So listen, I love the idea of intellectual and science and education and historical documents that can prove like Jesus existed and proof of God. That's great and that's valuable. But at the end of the day, he says, listen, if we love each other, then his love is brought to full expression. At the end of the day, people will know that God is real because of our love for one another. And that's crazy. People will see the divine. Something about your love for one another is going to pierce into their spirit, and it's going to convince them that, oh, maybe this God is real. So maybe, yes, science and intellect and education and history, yes. But at the end of the day, it's that love that's going to pierce the heart. And that's that love that we have for one another. And that's crazy. That love is what's going to prove to God, that prove that to others that God exists. And look at this verse. And God has given us his spirit as proof that we live in him and he in us. And let me just skip over here to the end. It says here in this last part here at the bottom, and he has given us this command. What's the command? Those who love God must also love their fellow believers. What's the message of John? I don't know, Pastor. You know, I don't think we can figure out what it means. I'm just being silly when I say that. It's to love each other. It's to love one another. And man, what a beautiful message that God's bringing to us. Because you know what it does? It helps us, particularly those that kind of maybe were raised religious, and we, you know, they can get complicated with that rules and regulations and requirements and all these endless list of demands. No, it just kind of scraps all that and says, listen, here's two things for you: faith and love, and loving each other. And what a beautiful, beautiful thing. All right, Chuck. Well, if you don't mind coming up here to close us in prayer, then after Chuck prays, that concludes our service. Star Child, I think we need to go back with Pastor Lena to pray for her after the service. You guys can join us if you want for that prayer service, or just hang out and chat, and we'll definitely see you on Discord. Thanks, everyone.
Thank you, DJ. And dear Lord, thank you for this time for us to come together and just help us to make your love our abiding place, that we stay in it, and that we love each other through your power of your love for us, in Jesus' name. And Lord, I just ask a special blessing on all those here as we go forward and bring this back safely next week, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Thanks, Chuck. Thanks, everyone. We'll see you next week, and we'll see you on Discord.
Okay. Everybody can unmute their microphones now. And visit with one another. Hello, how are you doing?
How are you? Doing,
Barb Rand? Hi.
Hi. What's new with you, Chuck?
Oh, I did 70 laps in the pool today. Y'all wow. don't know how difficult that is for me. That's a tough thing.